You know, some people have fooled us into thinking the world is flat, right? Other people say the world is curved. People like me say the world is open. Open? Open. When you have smart globes from Oregon Scientific, which are interactive with the USB port in it, you know, the world is truly open, but the world's open in many other kinds of ways today for learning. In fact, there are many ways in which we can collaborate with people around the world. In fact, there are books about this today, about global perspectives on collaboration, global education. Many people talking about the fact that we can now work with anyone else from anywhere at any time all around the world. And that's the premise of this program, this short 10-minute video pod. So we're going to go into this little section here today on global connections and collaborations. The trend is to move towards international collaborations and global interactions, but you need to have agreements. You need to have partnerships. You need to have contracts. You need to have memorandums of understanding. Experiment, pilot, trial things, but do talk to one another about what you're attempting to do. Are you going to do a wiki activity and bring in people from around the world, like bring in school children and teachers from the Netherlands and other parts of Europe? Are you going to bring in researchers from Brazil and other Latin American and South American countries? Are you going to bring in people from Africa or watch a video created in current television on a school or a business in Africa and then bring that person into your class? Whatever it is, you're going to be sharing new perspectives with people around the world, and your students will find out. Not only that, they'll construct knowledge, they'll negotiate, they'll interact. The rationale here is teamwork skills, reflection skills, perspective taking, construction. I mean, really, these are higher order deep things that we want in our classes across any discipline. We want to move from silo-based types of learning with technology to global perspective taking, collaborative, using technology as a social medium. But to do that on a global scale requires us to rethink our schedules, to think about timelines, because in Asia, classes might start later than in America. Same is true in Europe, right? Think about timelines for your class. Think about what you do at the end in terms of celebrating success. And then if you use one course management or learning management system to be able to enroll students in that one system, think about the interoperability across all systems and of that content produced by your students. And think about how grading might take place in different classes or for their global work, as well as communication. Will it be in English? Will they use a language translation tool? Will they need to know other languages? How will you convene your classes? Will you need to have your headsets on with your students to collaborate and share and discuss and so forth for team meetings? At the K-12 level, there are many things that have happened during the past 2 decades, in fact. We've been doing online collaboration between kids in schools for cultural exchanges, food projects, storytelling. There are adventure projects where people are in the Arctic, like my friend Aaron Daring at the University of Minnesota, going to Greenland, Iceland, Baffin Islands. There are flat classroom projects where kids analyze books across classrooms around the world. There is scientific research being done at the North and South Poles, shared with kids in schools. So again, my friend Aaron Daring taking off on his missions to the Arctic and talking to kids in schools live with his research data. EPALS and IEARN projects have been doing things of this nature where kids communicate and collaborate with others and pick a country. Teachers pick countries to work with. Global Nomads Group, which lets students in America talk to kids in Iran, India, Afghanistan, Brazil. The Flat Classrooms Project from Julie Lindsay and Vicky Davis, where they are located in different countries. Vicky in Georgia, Julie in Bangladeshi or China currently, or Qatar, wherever, and they analyze books together, like Thomas Friedman's World is Flat book they might analyze as a group class project. Ice Stories Project, where kids can talk to people studying the Antarctic toothfish, like Cassandra Brooks here, and ask questions while she's on her email 1 hour a day through satellite But it's not just K-12. There's a lot happening in higher education as well, with international video conferencing, case-based learning, students solving cases online, whether it's in teacher education, business, or whatever, or doing mock tour packages for each other. Many video conferencing activities taking place with large scales. Students in Korea here in this case. Or maybe small scale, where students sitting alone on vacation or on a remote site. Maybe they're located in a remote part of Alaska or Russia or somewhere. Or having a case writer planted in a business, sending back a case for students to solve in a live class like James Thorek's classes do in Massachusetts. Or maybe having global teams solving problems where their paired students are given a case to solve, pairs coming from different campuses. Or at the University of Illinois, they do mock tour packages for other students around the world, for students in Korea and other places to take on. You have many kinds of things that you can do online for collaboration today, whether it's photo media, engineering competition, computer science competitions. You might find ideas in Merlot. Go to merlot.org for ideas for your discipline. Once you do, you might explore them. My friend Rick Bennett does online photo media in the Omnium project from the University of New South Wales with creative wave competitions, he calls them. Other people have engineering classes, computer science classes, where students in Columbia University work with students in Sweden and India and Netherlands to solve problems, or computer game jams, or electronic war game collaborations, students designing games in different locations around the world, competing with one another, or maybe writing books, wiki books, or doing glossaries together, or lesson plans, simulations, games, maybe bringing in guest experts from around the world in virtual collaborations, online rhetoric projects from Stanford with students coming from other countries around the world, wiki books I mentioned. My students have been doing this with students from University of Houston and Hawaii, Grace Lynn at Hawaii, my friend Mimi Lee at Houston, other places. We've been doing wiki book projects for a number of years. Students collaborating with students in China, Malaysia, Korea. You name it, you can do this in wiki books. Or maybe having your students write a book for someone in another country, right? So you might do that as well in the Global Text Project, writing books for third world countries. Maybe bringing students into your classes, like in virtual worlds, having students explore virtual worlds as teams, class meetings in virtual worlds, hot tub chats with guest authors. You could have all sorts of things in virtual worlds that are team-based. Maybe it's an emergency room preparedness training for medical people. Maybe bringing people in for webinars that might be guest experts in your classes that you might be reading about, and then you bring them in from all around the world. Whatever it is, determine your schedule. Make sure that all instructors agree on that schedule. Check out the sites that you're going to be using. Check out the technology. Make sure your students might be in China, can access it, maybe through a proxy server. Make sure they're familiar with it. Get them to introduce each other through icebreaking activities. Post up their profiles with one another, and then experiment with one or two technologies. Not too many. Maybe try a wiki or try a blog. Get them in a social networking account like Twitter or Facebook. If you can't find an organization to work with, or find a school or university to work with, maybe there's a website that promotes it. Maybe there's someone who's looking to do something like this. Find someone at a conference and talk to them about your interest in doing this. And then when you've done it, present back at that conference so people can be aware of what you're doing. The more you present to others, the more likely you'll get people saying, hey, let's try this out, let's do this. So look up professional organizations in your discipline. Look for mentors and experts. Maybe invite them in for a symposia or some kind of colloquia with experts around the world. Maybe attend a global conference like Global Time, Global Learn, go to EDUCAUSE or Eden or something to that effect. The time is ripe for trying something like this out. Time is ripe for taking your students on a spin around the world with you. Do some collaboration with students in Chile or Australia or Africa or wherever you might want to land, maybe even Canada, right? So find a place that might be willing, interested. Miss Fiji, for instance. You wouldn't believe the excitement that can happen in your classes when you do online collaboration. So try it out. Hopefully you're convinced to try this. Hopefully you'll collaborate. Collaborate or die. Take a chance. Good luck with you.